So this is actually going to be my final update for the Finish 7 by Spring for 2017 challenge. And even though I did include 10 items in hopes of finishing off 7 of them, I still was not able to finish off 7. So let me show you real fast what was finished off at the last update, since there was only one of them. And this is it here. This is the Creme de Rose from Dior. This is a smoothing, plumping lip balm, it's described as, and I don't feel as though it necessarily plumps up your lips at all. It is a nice lip balm. I'll put this on before I start doing the rest of my makeup, and then by the time I'm done with my face makeup or my eyes or whatever, my lips are hydrated and ready for any sort of lipstick that I want to put on. So I do like this, but I don't think I want to spend that $30 again. So this one is still available at Sephora. I think somebody asked me last time that they had thought that it was discontinued, but I think it's still available at Sephora for sure. I know that much. And then, since the last update, I was only able to finish off a couple of these, but most of these just had a little bit left in them, so it's not that big of a surprise. But the first one is my Guess perfume right here. This is a 1.7 fluid ounce bottle, and when I started this challenge, I was right there at that line, so just about the halfway mark. So there was under a fluid ounce of liquid in here. At the last update, I had to mark on the packaging right there because the perfume was so far down in here. I really did like this perfume. It's a kind of a fresh, kind of crisp perfume. I do like it. I think it's perfect for the fall time, the winter, spring. I prefer a sweeter scent in the summer months, but this is essentially a year-round fragrance to me. So I really did enjoy this one. Happy to see it moved out of the way. I did finish off my Makeup Forever Lab Shine lip gloss. This one was in D16. This is just one of the nude ones, and I was right about there at the last update, and like I said, I popped the stopper out of this one and cleaned it all out. I had this little contraption that can reach down at the bottom of your lip glosses. It was sent to me from Kristen K here on YouTube, so I really did appreciate that item for getting the last little bit of the lip gloss out of here. I'll put a link down in the description box if it's still available at Sephora. I believe that's where she got it from, but I loved this lip gloss so much that I broke into my other backup of this. This is my very last one, so I was using this with the lipstick that's in this project, so I didn't make very much progress on this guy, but I just wanted to mention I finished that other one off and then started using this one with it. The lipstick that I was using in combination with this Lab Shine lip gloss was the Chanel Coco Rouge Coco Shine lipstick in number 54 Boy. And this one is completely flat against the metal. So yeah, I could, you know, scrape out the product from in here. I think what I'm gonna do, I might do that a little bit, but I'm gonna take the lipstick out of here so I can show you guys how I depot lipsticks. I mentioned, I think when I uploaded my makeup inventory the last time, there was my Dior lipstick tube that I had put one of my Wet n Wild lipsticks in it, and so I had a couple people ask me about how I did that. So you just have to find the right shape of lipstick to go in the tube that you want to put it in. So I'll hang on to this and save it for making that video where I depot another lipstick into here, but I was really happy to have this guy finished off. This one was kind of expensive. Then this one, I'm really proud of this one. It was a very small item to begin with, but I do not like these products, so I'm very happy that I was able to use this one up and get it out of the way. This is the Tarte Cheek Stain in the shade Flush, I guess is how I would say that. So it's just this little deluxe size sample, and you can see my marks on the side here. That's where I was at the intro first update, and there was just a tiny little bit left in here, and I finished it off. So if you look on the inside of this container, you can see that's a decent amount of, you know, cream blush in this product, but if I roll this up all the way, it looks like there's a ton left in here, but this is actually the plastic holding it on there, holding the product in the container. So when that's rolled all the way down, that's how I was measuring it. That's how I held it up against here, so you can see That's how much I used up for this project. So really happy about this one. I am not a cream blush fan. This one wasn't that bad. I would put it on my stippling brush and then put it towards the back of my cheeks, and I think it worked out just fine that way. And then I could layer, you know, lighter blushes and powder blushes over the top of it. So since the last time, I had these four that were finished off. And including the one from the first update, I had 5 items finished in this project for this year. Looking at these other ones, I could have put more of an effort into some of these other products for sure. So this next one is the Clinique Super Primer Universal Face Primer. And this is a pretty impressive product. It feels sort of like a lotion. If you have dry skin, I think this is a really nice primer, honestly. I don't hear a lot of people talking about this at all, but I thought it went on really nice and smooth. But I don't wear a primer on a daily basis. I either forget about it, I don't feel like they're completely necessary, and unless they're giving me like a dewy glow, I usually don't remember to reach for them. So anyway, I was right up here at the intro video. I got down to there at the first update, and at the finale, I am right down to here. So I tried to use this on a consistent daily basis after my last update. I think it was somewhere between 15 and 17 days since the last update, so that amount of progress, not too bad for just over 2 weeks. I was trying to use it on a daily basis. I set it out so I would see it every day, and I still forgot a couple of the days, but I think I did a pretty good job, especially since this first one was over a month of progress up there. So I don't think that this will take me very long. This one should be in an empties video very soon. I had my Tarte Park Avenue Princess Bronzer. I was kind of bummed that I didn't use this one consistently and have this finished off. So this is what the bronzer looks like here, but it was a pretty big item. This one came loose in here, so I have to, let me push it down so it's in the right spot. So this is what is left in this bronzer right here. Not very much at all, so I really don't think that it's going to take very long to use up, but it'll definitely take me maybe another month. So hopefully this one will be in my April empties, but that is what it's looking like so far. Sometimes I would even toss this into like the crease of my eye or something and just kind of blow it out if I was having a really light makeup day or something. So I like this product, but I wish I would have finished it off. Then I have my Coco eyeliner. This is their, what are these called? Well, I sharpened off the writing, so I don't have it. I'll put it up on the screen if I remember, but they have the little brush on the one end, and then you pull this top part off and you have your eyeliner. This is a really pretty eyeliner. I'm kind of sad that it's almost finished, but you know, I've had it around for a while. I was right here, if you can see that, right there at the intro video. That was at the first update right there, and this is where I'm at currently. So I tried to use this either underneath the bottom lash line, like along here, or just smudged up against the upper lash line. So that is where I'm at with this guy. And like I said at the last update, it's probably only gonna sharpen to about right there-ish. So I'm almost done with this one, but you know, it's still hanging around. I think this one was their mystery eyeliner, and I think it was number 17, if I'm not mistaken. It's a really pretty, like, deep khaki color with these beautiful micro shimmers running through it. Really pretty liner. And then I have my last two products, and unfortunately, I really dropped the ball with these two. I had my Studio Tech Cream Foundation from MAC and the Radiant Creamy Concealer from NARS in Light 2 Vanilla. And honestly, I didn't use either one of these since the last update. Oh no, I take that back. I think I used this one like 3 times, but not enough. And I did not use this one at all. So let me show you where I'm at just so you can see. That is where I'm at in this MAC cream foundation. And I don't know, man. I just have a hard time using this. Did I use this one once? I can't remember if the pan was showing this much or not. It's been over 2 weeks, so I'm not 100% sure, but if I used it, I think I only used it once. So this is what it looks like in the container here. This foundation, if you use it on a daily basis, there's such little product in here that you can use this up within a month and a half. I've used up multiple of these in the past, but I have to use it on a really nice and a really hydrated skin day. If I don't, it looks super cakey and flaky and patchy and really yucky after a couple hours. So that's where I'm at with this one. I don't have any doubt that this will be finished off before the end of the year. Maybe I'll toss it into another project or something coming up. And then the other one, obviously the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer. I probably shouldn't have added this in to finish off. This just feels so thick and cakey on me, and I used to love this concealer, but it's really hard for me to use this now after I've used some of my other concealers consistently. If you look in here, I don't know if you'll be able to see it, but I have like a lot of air in here. If I run the brush up against the edge, there's, you know, definitely some space showing in here if I look down inside the tube, but it'll take a while to finish off. So this one, maybe it'll be finished by the end of the year, but anyway, that was it. I'll put the grand total of what I used up on the upper part of the screen there, but that is the overall worth of the products that I finished off. So say for like my Tarte product, obviously you can't purchase this in this teeny little size, but I take the amount that's in the full size and I get the price that's in the full size, and then I divide the ounces or the grams or whatever from the small one, and then I come up with the price that way, if that makes sense. So anyway, that's where I came up with the total right up there. That was it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know how you guys did, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.